Hello, this is Bern, and if you're interested in finding out 5 hidden reasons why you're not getting the love that you want, please stick around because I'll be sharing them with you on my episode today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to yourgreatlifetobe.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. Super pumped to be sharing with you 5 hidden reasons why you're not getting the love that you want. I'm just gonna head right into them. The first one is lack of emotional clarity about your awesomeness, about you, right? When you doubt your awesomeness, or when you lack emotional clarity around what are your virtues and what's the secret sauce, the magic sauce, the unique sauce that you bring to the table, and you shy away from it and you don't express it, that lack of emotional clarity about you prevents you from creating strong connections with men, which in turn creates this belief that it can't happen, or that men don't like you, or that it's harder than it needs to be. I'm not saying that it's easy, but you can make it harder by having a lack of focus as to how awesome you are. Number 2, lack of emotional clarity about him. You have a piece of paper that has certain qualities, but when you come face to face with a guy, you're not sure exactly if he's the guy for you or not, because you're not connected to your intuition in that moment, and because you haven't sat down to focus on what are the emotional qualities he needs to bring to the table. And there's no right or wrong. It's whatever works for you. Whatever works for person A will be completely the opposite of what's going to work for person B. But you need to find, is this guy going to be passionate or more reserved? Is this guy going to be really affectionate, or is he going to be the kind of guy that doesn't want to show affection in public? Is he somebody who really cherishes conversation, or do you love enjoying the silence with him more than having deep conversations? You have to get clear as to what are the emotional qualities that the man that you want needs to bring to the table, so that you can really create a stronger sense of resonance when you connect with someone. Does this feel right, or is this something that's on paper cool but completely opposite of what I want? Number 3, this is probably the biggest one of the 5 that I'm mentioning right now, so please write it down. The benefits that you subconsciously have for not getting the love are greater than the benefits for getting the love. And you're gonna say, well, Bern, you're fucking crazy right now. Of course I want the love. Really? Because getting the love would also mean that you have to spend less time on your own. Getting the love may mean that you have to commit doing shit that you're not super excited about. Getting the love means that you get to be fully seen in your naked splendor, physically, emotionally, spiritually, by someone. And that someone can choose to leave you. And then that feels devastating. So all those things that are lurking in the background may feel significantly heavier when you really focus on them than the benefit of, I have someone and I don't feel alone. Yeah, but the price of getting there is heavier in your subconscious mind. And that's why you're doing things to subconsciously not make it happen, connecting with men who are unavailable emotionally, so that when it doesn't happen, you never have to feel ultimately rejected. There's so many things that we do as human beings when we're unclear, or where we have hidden benefits for not getting what we want, that if you can get clear on what may be really stopping you and work on it, that may be the flood, open the floodgates to maybe 10 years of not getting what you want, boom, you finally get it. Okay, number 4, you're not putting in the right work to make it happen. Now, again, I could hear somebody say, well, why do women have to put on the work? The work doesn't mean you necessarily go out there and you ask guys out. The work might mean leaning back more, right? The work might mean saying fuck you to guys who are not good for you, ending relationships that are painful. I'm not saying with the work that you have to go out there and fish for a man. I'm saying that sometimes the work is stepping more into your feminine, doing less, opening more. So that's what I'm referring to. And guys should do the work as well, right? But if you're not doing your share, then, and it's not happening, don't blame it on poor quality guys. The guys that you're connecting with and that are staying in your life, right? Because you can connect with guys that are not worthy, but if you're, these are the kind of guys who stick in your life, there's something that you could be doing differently, even if it's just saying no more consistently, right? The 5th one, you're putting in the right work, but you haven't put in the work long enough. I hate the word patience, because I myself, I'm not a patient person, but I know I need to step into it many times, and so do you, right? When it hasn't been long enough, when you've been, I get messages from some people sometimes that say, hey, Bern, I've been doing all the shit that you share on the videos and it's been 2 months and it hasn't happened. Well, sometimes you need hand-holding from mentorship, and that's the case, right? But sometimes it hasn't been long enough. Sometimes you're doing things and you've been 40 fucking years doing it the wrong way, and now you're doing it the right way, but it's only been 2 months. So you need to step into it with more power and presence, or get someone to help you see what you're not seeing within yourself. That's also something important. So hope this is helpful, useful, insightful to you in some way. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do 3 things. Number 1, click like on this video. Number 2, subscribe to my channel. Number 3, somewhere on the description of this video or on your screen, you'll see a pop-up show up that will allow you to sign up to a webinar that I'm hosting that will share with you a blueprint to find your soulmate in 9 days or less. Super powerful stuff, and it's absolutely free. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and I challenge you as always to live a full and a conscious life.